Here's a quick guide on how you can import USDZ files, which are Apple's own 3D format, straight into Reality Composer. You can get USDZ files from lots of different places, or you can make them yourself using apps like Clone. Check out the 3D Warehouse, and the NASA website linked below has got loads of great models. In fact, I'm going to use the NASA website now, and I'm going to scroll down till I find a model I like the look of, and I'm going to download that into the Files app on my iPad. Now let's jump straight into Reality Composer, where I've got a new horizontal workspace, and I've deleted all the objects on there. So let's press the plus button to add a new object, and this time we're going to add a new one from File. So we'll tap on the plus button, and then we can navigate using the Files app to find our download. When I import it, you should see it drop straight onto the page, just like any other object from the Reality Composer library. And of course, you can manipulate this by moving it through the X, Y, and Z axes, you can change the scale, you can rotate it, and position wherever you like. Another way to get your new models into Reality Composer is to swipe up from the bottom of your iPad to show the dock, and then to drag the Files app over to the side of your screen. Navigate the folder where all your downloads are saved, and you can literally drag and drop straight from Files onto Reality Composer and drop it where you want on the page. Really simple and really quick, and again, you'll get that fully detailed model ready to go. When you press the AR button in the top corner, you'll get to view your new models up close, and the USDZ file format allows for loads of detail and precision, so if we get really close to the Mars rover, you can see all of the detail there on that model from NASA. Again, all of these NASA models are completely free, and there are loads more online as well, which can interact with your existing models and objects in Reality Composer. The possibilities are truly endless. Hey, thanks for watching that video. Now, if you enjoyed that and you want to find some more quick tips for your iPad or to use in your classroom, do me a favour and press the subscribe button down below. That will really help me out, and it will help you keep up to date with all the latest tips and tricks on my YouTube channel.